In this lesson, we'll look at adding cross-origin resource sharing, or CORS, to our application. So, cross-domain headers are an issue with REST applications. When an application tries to access your REST service and it's on another domain, the browser will block your attempt to access the service. So what the problem is basically you're limited to the server will only allow clients from its own domain. So if I have a web application that's at a different domain, like example.com, or for a better example, if I have like an HTML5 client that's stored on my local disk, and I try to access a REST application on oracle.com, then I'm going to get some sort of error message saying you're violating the same origin policy and you are unable to connect. So as a solution to this, you can add cross-origin resource sharing, or CORS, to your application. And what this does is it allows you to add headers to your web service which allow your clients to communicate with your server. So these headers identify what resources can be accessed, which methods, HTTP methods, are allowed, and things like how long the data can be cached from that server. So if you want to read up more on this subject, it is a W3C standard, and there's some links that would be useful. These will also be provided in the resources for the course. So as an example, here are some headers that if you turn on CORS, what they would look like. So the first one there, access control allow origin, that specifies what resource you have access to. So this example, you would have access to the entire web server, but typically it would be something like this plus slash employees or something, some specific resource you'd have access to. Then you can also specify what methods are available, what headers you can use, and then things like if you can use credentials to connect to the service or not. And these are just some examples of some of the headers. There are more than this. So how do we do that with our Spring Boot application? How do we provide CORS support? Well, of course, at Spring Boot, we have an annotation for that at cross origin. You apply that to a method or a class, and then your application has cross-origin support. So in our sample application, what we're going to do is we're just going to add that annotation to our class. And so if we add that to employee controller right there, then our application is now CORS enabled. And you want to do this for your application as one of the final steps to make it complete, to make it a complete application so that you can access it if you run the client from like your local hard disk or something. Okay, so we've covered CORS support for your application, and that completes this lesson.